That's why I call my thing the marathon, because I'm not gonna lie and portray this ultimate poise like I've been had it figured out. Nah, I just didn't quit. That's the only distinguishing quality from me and probably whoever else going through this or went through this or is gonna go through this, is that I ain't quit. I went through every emotion. I went through every emotion with trying to pursue what I'm doing, you know what I mean? And I think that what's gonna separate whoever's gonna try to go for something is that you ain't gonna quit. Unless, you know, you're gonna really take the stance if I'm gonna die behind what I'm getting at right now.
Future of the sport, 1,000%.
Here at the press conference with Javonte Tank Davis. Hey, tell everybody your name, big dog. All
right, man, my name is Jaleel Haggett, 16-year-old amateur, soon to be pro.
Matter of fact, Mr. Ellaby, man, was giving you high praise today, man. How did it feel, man, to get such high praise from Mr. Leonard Ellaby, man?
That feel real good.
Let me ask you, how you able to turn pro at 16, man?
It's a lot of paperwork and stuff they got to go through, but man, they said they can make it happen, so it's like, they make it happen, it's time for me to go fight.
Now, you know one of my first questions, man. Yeah. What happened to the Olympics 2020, man?
I won't be old enough, sadly,
oh,
man.
Oh, that's, you know, right, the age.
It's 19 through 40, I'll be 16, so it's like, it won't happen.
Are you nervous, man, going up?
No, not at all. I've been doing this my whole life.
Now, what was your amateur record?
About 130 and 19.
Oh, wow, man. Where were you fighting out of?
I'm fighting out of Washington, D.C. for Athletic Republic.
Athletic Republic. Oh, wow, man. When did Mr. Lenny Ellaby actually catch an eye of you, man?
Not too long ago, actually. I didn't know he knew about me. It was surprising to me, man. Once I found out he knew about me, it was just... We talking, man. We got big news coming soon.
How it's like growing up in D.C., man? I'm also a D.C. native, man.
Man, it's tough. It depends on where you at in D.C.
It's crazy. It's not like the old D.C. Yeah, I grew up in the 80s. You
yeah,
know.
It's different. It depends on what part you're in. But yeah. For me, it was nice having my mom and my dad. So it's like, everything was smooth.
Now I got to ask you, man. What was your parents like when you decided that you wanted to go pro, man?
Man, they was, my dad was all for it. My mom, she was like, man, I've been watching you do this since you was 8 years old. I'm not going to stop you now. So it's like, yeah.
Do you know when you're going to have your first professional fight?
Not yet. It's looking like the end of this year or the beginning of the next year.
Oh, wow, man. What's the preparation like to get ready to turn pro? I know it has to be different from the amateur.
Different, man. Every once in a while, get like 2 or 3 rounds of no headgear on just to get used to it. Working with a lot of pros. Getting a lot of tips from like older pros and stuff. So it's like, it's a different level.
Who did you get a chance to work with?
I've been working with Shakur Stevenson. Well, I've got work with Shakur Stevenson over at the Russell's Boxing Gym. I've been getting to work with a lot of different pros, man.
So what do you do to stay busy, man?
Running, staying in shape. If a lot of people know about me. One thing they do know about Jaleel Haggett is Jaleel Haggett always got gas. Jaleel Haggett will do 100 rounds if you want him to.
Oh, you want to break that smoke.
Yeah.
Hey, man, let me ask you, man, who are some of your favorite fighters out there?
Favorite fighters? I got two favorites right now.
Who's that?
Right now, at the bigger weight classes, it's Triple G, despite the loss. Still one of my favorite fighters at the bigger weight classes. And at the smaller weight class, right now, it got to be Tough Stuff.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what's up, man. Do you know what your weight gonna be when you start fighting professionally?
9 times out of 10, I'll be probably fighting 135. Talk it over with the team.
With
a
135.
Talk it over with the team, probably fighting 135.
That's a lot of smoking at 135.
Definitely.
But I think you can do it, man. I really appreciate your time, man.
Thank you,
running
tight
up a DC native up here, man. We're gonna do big things, man. Tell everybody your name again, big dog.
All right, my name is Jaleel Haggett, and crazy as you say, you can follow me on Instagram at BigDog_J.
Oh,
BigDawg _JAY.
That's
Thank
what's
you.
Up, man. I appreciate your time, big dog.
All right, man. All the time.
Here right here, special, man. Special. Inside and outside the ring. He's gonna be a world champion one day. And I don't understand that with anybody.
Straight out of D.C.
Straight out of D.C. That's my hometown.
Your hometown?
D.C.
Born and raised. Dunbar High School.
Yeah, and this kid is he's special, man. They don't come off. Tank is special.
Be on the lookout for him. I said
be on the lookout for him. Jaleel Haggett. we got plans for this kid. And everything gonna work out right.
All right, we out.
Trust me, this kid is gonna be a world champion. I'm telling you. I'm telling you.
Hear that, man. We
and
out.
Of course, he's gonna be a brother Mayweather promotion.
That's right. The money to you, baby. What's good, people? I'm out here.
Oh,
up
yeah,
there.
Yeah.
Hey, how it feel to get that work in, big dog?
Man, I feel real good. I'm getting good quality work. People gonna bring it. They ain't no BS or none of that.
Now, what made your way up there for the training and workout, man? Because last time we talked, we were at the Jamonte Tank Davis homecoming press conference.
Yeah.
And remember, I was talking about that, the invites to come up here for the camp. So what made you come up for the camp?
After the press conference was over, we talked to Calvin. Calvin said, man, we definitely want you up here for the work leading up to the fight. So I was like, man, why not?
Hey, man, how's the work been so far, man?
Great. Great. I've been getting lovely work, man. All dog work.
All dog work?
Yeah.
All right, I'm out here with Jaleel Hackett. Just got finished sparring rounds with Tank, man. How do you feel, man?
Good, man. Definitely a different level of work, man. See, I got a little cut.
Explain that to people, man, when you say different level of work.
Different level of work. It's different between working with a world-class amateur and a world-class pro. Big difference. Speed is different. Reaction time is different. A lot of things are different.
Just from your quick sparring session, that was four rounds, right?
Yeah, that was four.
What did you learn from the session today?
Reaction time is different. It's split-second reaction time. You always got to stay set, ready to fire.
Hey, man, for 16, man, you put in some work in there, man. I appreciate it, man. Hard work, man. And I appreciate the hard work and dedication that you're putting on, man.
All the time, all the time.
All the time, man. You see, man, you don't play boxing, man.
You can't play this. You got to do this.
Well, believe
real.
Me, he handled his own out there, man. Good job in there, man.
Always.
All right, man.
If you're trying to do something in life, get with somebody that's in that field and talk to them to help you get where you're going at. It's like a counselor. And I guarantee you will see results.
I got to ask you about one young man before I wrap up, because I'm going to go actually see him later on, and that's Jaleel Hackett.
Oh, man, Jaleel, he can't wait. He came to me and thanked me. He said, man, he learned so much in the period of time that he was down here, but Jaleel always had it. He a hard worker, him and his dad, you know what I'm saying? Anybody asked me anything about him, which they have, you know what I'm saying? I gave him nothing but praises because I know he's going to do the right things.
Out here at the Athletic Republic, I have the owner. Talk about this whole experience that you have out here.
Well, I mean, this is our investment in the youth dreams in our community, man. You know, so many kids, all they need is an opportunity and someone to believe in them and that's willing to push them to the next level. In a space like this, we've been all over the country, LA, California, you know, other areas had this. But really not areas like this, where it's our kids and our people in this space. That's why we created it, man.
It's a hell of a facility, man. Thanks. You got the ring here, you got the octagon here,
yep.
Bags here, simulation of a soccer field, and I seen a young lady doing the deadlifts over there.
Yeah, we got the deadlifts, we got hot yoga back there, we got the Zumba room. Like, we really want this a space for it's holistic development, right? It's not just you. It's not just sports. It's the entire family. The parents can come in here. They can run the track. They can work, get their workout in. And the kids can still be working towards their dream all at the same time. If you do it on the field, if you're doing it on the court, you can come here and get better at it.
And then one of the things that you did was be a sponsor for Jaleel Hackett, yeah. Man. How did that whole process come about?
It was seamless. It was a natural marriage. As soon as we met Jaleel, he's exactly the type of kid that we wanted to invest in. You know, he's got a great village around him, great family support, but the kid works like he don't know where his next meal is going to come from. And that's all that we ask, is that when the youth come in here, that they're dedicated to what they do, and we'll provide them with anybody else, with everything else. I don't know anybody that's more dedicated than Jaleel is and what he's doing.
Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We were all meant to shine as children do. It's not just in some of us, it's in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same, as we are liberated from our own fear. Our presence automatically liberates others.
Another young man in the camp,
that you said will be the future of boxing, Jaleel Hackett. He's been doing his thing again.
Yeah, yeah. He's a nice young kid. His dad is his backbone. You know, he comes from a good, solid family, you know, spearheaded by his dad. We have a very good relationship, and I'm excited about the young man. He's a tremendous talent, and he's got a very, very bright future.
I got to ask you, man, what are your thoughts on Jaleel Hackett's performance at the camp?
I think he did very well. I think he showed very excellent for himself, showed his potential, worked with some great fighters in camp, as well as working with Tank.
What did Jaleel say he learned the most from the camp? Just speaking with you about it.
To me, it was the speed. Being able to not being more into the volume of punches, but knowing the reaction time and the speed of what's going on. That was the biggest thing he said he got from the camp.
Now, with his performance at the camp, he's had a lot of eyes on him.
Yeah.
The letter LB, for example.
Yeah, yeah.
Has there been any discussions or talks about that?
I'm pretty sure that he's falling in love with them and they've fallen in love with him. And we're going forward hoping things will work out to be maybe late this year he'll make his move into the pro ranks.
Oh, wow. That soon?
Yes.
Wow.
He's done what he wanted to do as an amateur. Had a good amateur career. Opportunities like this, thanks to Calvin Ford, Leonard Ellerby, and that whole Mayweather Promotions team, showed that he's ready to do the next step. He's done everything correctly. I was appreciative of Tank for, you know, basically saying, hey, this kid can go. This kid, and giving him the opportunity to come in camp and prove he was worth coming in camp. It's not just a gift to come in camp and be in there. You got to remember, Tank is doing this for his living. So he's not giving gifts of coming to camp, son, I'll teach you. Being able to have the opportunity to come in there and being told to stay, that was a big thing.
It's funny that it's interesting that you say that because, you like you said, it was a learning process in the beginning, you know, just to learn the quickness and the speed that we actually talked about, because he actually got a cut one time up in the camp.
Yeah, and once again, can't play this sport, can't play boxing. He took a relaxation break during a round and got caught with a good shot and got cut. But in the baddest of good ways, I saw how he responded under adversity, and he still continued as he was doing prior to the cut. So that showed me a lot.
It definitely showed his tenacity and spirit and heart, because after that, man, he really showed out in camp, man. Yeah, just really did his thing.
Yeah, he learned a lot and he got to show what his metal was made of.
And for, like you said, you're looking, because earlier we had talked about he was looking more towards next year, but with this opportunities that are coming along, you're looking like more like the fourth quarter of the year.
Boxing is what I like to tell a lot of people is turning into AAU basketball. You got a kid playing AAU basketball and he gets opportunities to play with the current pros and he does what they expected him to do later. You got to take opportunities when they come. You know, this is like life-changing situations. A lot of fighters go through coming up the hard ranks, chilling circuit and doing those type of things. But when you get the eye of somebody who can say, hey, we can put you in a different perspective of life, you got to take your opportunities.
Hey, man, I really appreciate your time. I'm really proud of Jaleel and the things he's doing straight out of D.C.
Man, I appreciate you, man. The coverage you give to young fighters and fighters who don't normally have those opportunities, it does help change the narrative on them because now they get to a different fan base. We're in a social media-driven world. And if you're not connected with those people who can get you to the masses, it's hard. So I appreciate you.
I gotta ask you, you know what you say about your philosophy of going slow on the mitts?
Uh-huh.
Why you think people so impressed by the speed on the mitts?
Cause it look good, it's cute. I love it too, man. I love to see that. I've seen, I'm gonna say this. I've seen
myself personally, two fighters ever box and could do the mitts and make it look exactly the same. Two fighters I've seen. The first one, Floyd Mayweather Jr. He can, the mitt and boxing, same way. The second, with the speed, Jerry Russell Jr. Only two I've ever seen do it. So if I've only seen two people throw a 15-piece combination on a set of mitts and then do it in the ring, why would I teach them something that 98% of the other people have failed at? I'd rather you be more, when I like to see the mitts, I tell you, I used to like to watch do the mitts. Gerald McCluckin, the G-Man. His mitts were not fast, but it was the same way he fought. He's here, his mitts will be the same way. Bing, bing, and right here. It wasn't a change. If you're gonna do anything in this sport, be able to make it where you can do it in the ring. How many fighters you seen, whether it's on YouTube or whatever, throw these very beautiful, intricate combinations?
In the ring, I haven't.
No. In the mitts. You can see hundreds of videos where they YouTube legends because they can throw a 25-punch combination. How many of those fighters have you ever seen remotely throw the same combination in a fight?
I haven't.
How many of them have you ever seen attempt to throw those combinations in a fight?
You don't.
How many of them have you ever seen have the gas and stamina to even look like the same fighter that they are on the mitts or on the bag when they fight? It's beautiful, don't get me wrong, I like it. But it's not something that I want to teach my son to do. That doesn't make sense.
Quick, now, your preference, do you prefer the mitts or the heavy bag?
Both of them actually give you a lot. I think with the mitts, you can put a man in front of you that can emulate certain movements. With the heavy bag, you can learn to correctly throw something. If you're the coach, you can watch from the outside.
Yeah, I heard Carissa Shields' coach talking about that.
Yeah, I can be on the outside and look at you and be like, man, you ain't do that on the mitts. You ever seen coach say, stop, come here. Now let me see that on the mitts. They be like, why is it different on here than there? Because now they get to see when they're in the middle of the action, they really don't see it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that to me is the biggest thing. I'm with him, I'm more or less wanting perfection. You don't have to be the fastest guy. You don't have to be the strongest guy. But I will not accept you not being the most perfect guy. We four fighters that's been faster than us. We four fighters that have been stronger than us. Come out on top. We've had fights where my son has chosen to do it his way, and we've lost. Because he won't do it his way. We've had fights where I tell him after the fight, and I told other people, it was my bad call. But for the most part, we've had fights where we've been able to dominate because of how we do. It's not accidental that I make him run the way I do. It's not accidental that I think we do more strength and conditioning than we do boxing. Once he know how to fight, he know how to fight. Let's focus on making it where we can do something the next man can. If I can get him to run 7 miles, and after 7 miles and I got him on the clock, say, come on, gee up, we're gonna spot. And he can tell his body to recover fast enough to go work, I can live with that. I mean, when you seen him spar, he can be dominant by just walking you down. But he can also say, let's box. Let's get some rounds in. That's what I like about the sport of boxing. Every coach, whether it's Calvin Ford, whether it's Gary Russell Sr., whether it's Barry Hunter, whether it's Kenny Porter, name all the coaches you want. Each one of those coaches in their own way is a Picasso. They just throw the paint on the canvas differently.
Different.
But at the end of the day, they all have masterpieces. All those guys I just named have world champions. That means that at some point in time, they created a masterpiece. So it's no one way to do it. It's the best way as a coach for you to get your fighter to bring it out on the canvas.
Time on through all this pain.
All middle. It's all middle.
Yeah, hold that time.
It's all middle, man. All middle.
Hold it. Give out.
Hey, it ain't middle, man. It ain't physical. It's all mental in your mind.
That's an earth point.
It's all middle.
Shaking like it's a
soul middle. Shaker. It's middle.
Like a soul shaker, Jack.
It ain't physical. Look, it's middle. In this turn. We definitely make champions. We definitely make champions over this promotion.
That man want to see your blood on front of his money. He want to see your blood on front of his money, Jack.
We make champions over this promotion.
He got a list of belts on the back of there, and he said, I want them all. He wants why he don't drive himself home because he give up the work to exhaust. And he knew it, he wanted everybody else to do it. Come on, get
it. While they ain't doing it, we gonna be doing it.
They take a break, get working.
Starting at night, but it ended till dawn.
Yeah.
All popping like like some corn in the microwave. Moonwalking to the money like I'm Michael J. Make boppers with ease. Got the science of this shit. She get a degree. Now the party going up by a couple.
Champs, Mr. Lamont here, who runs Four Champs. I want to thank Mayweather Promotions for believing in me. I want to thank my man Rafiq for giving me some beautiful work today. And man, I want to thank everybody else who supports me. Without y'all, I wouldn't be anybody. So man, thank y'all a lot.
Cut.
Now, why I have you, man? I got to ask you about this young man right here, Jaleel Hackett.
Oh yeah. Oh, he got next. Right now, this young man, he's 16 years old.
Graduating early.
That just goes to show you the importance of education. And he's a great example of what that's all about. You know, he's gonna have a very, very, very bright future. And we're just excited. You know, this is my guy right here. And like I said, you're gonna be seeing a lot of him.
Now, with that being said, you know, Mayweather Promotion is really tapping into the Baltimore DMV market. What is it about this area in boxing that really has your eye focused on this area right now?
The talent.
As compared to other cities.
The talent. You know, I'm from the DMV. I'm from DC. So I know it's just that it's taking us a little longer to get here, but we here now. It's a wrap. It's a wrap. I'm telling you.
A lot of people don't remember. He's the only city that had four world champions in one time.
Yeah, that's true.
Mark Two Shaw Charles, Sean B. Mitchell, Keith Holm, and William Jackson.
Yeah. All at the same time.
All at the same time. Yeah.
And held it for years.
Yeah. And that's the truth.
Hey, man, I really appreciate your time today, man.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. We out.